Here we go. Okay, this is the first video that I've uploaded in quite some time. I've just not been in the mood and I've not been healthy enough to really dedicate much time or energy to that. I'm now out of the woods, as they say, and I'm back and going to make some videos. Now, one of the first videos I want to show you today is a short version of Turn of the Century by Steve Howe and the group Yes from the album Going for the One. Now, many years ago, Steve Howe released a DVD cd-rom thing with a lot of an instructional thing. I have never had a copy in my hand, but I've seen it online, and it's very difficult to find this thing. Fortunately, on YouTube, a guy uploaded the videos from the DVD or the cd-rom. And it's the version that he plays on that, the short version of Turn of the Century, that I'd like to show you now. When you learn this piece, there's a couple of things that you really help you understand how Steve Howe plays guitar, which is not a bad thing. You know, he has a very unique style playing guitar, and he's so proficient and original in so many different styles. He always pulls them all together into one piece. The nice thing about learning this short version of Turn of the Century is that if you're playing somewhere and there's a Yes fan and you learn this, you can play it for them. You don't have to sit and go. A lot of reverb on that. I'll turn the reverb in down a bit. So you don't have to learn something as complicated as that. You could learn this Turn of the Century. It's not that difficult. One of the techniques that Steve Howe uses in this song is he's using a lot of octave work. I'm sure he's deeply influenced by a guy called Wes Montgomery. You can watch Rick Beato's video and various videos of Wes Montgomery. Wes Montgomery is an amazing guitar player. Doesn't matter what kind of music you like, when you listen to him playing, you know that you're being sort of washed over by genius guitar playing. So here's the deal. What he does is he plays octaves. So if you're playing the A string on the seventh fret, the E note, you would octave that by playing the B string on the fifth fret of the, yeah? And play two together. And you can slide that up and down anywhere on the neck, you get that. And you can cross strings, usually between the A and the D string. And you're pulling the two of them together. I'm using a pick and my finger. But sometimes jazz players will play. And they're muting the other strings. Anyway, so the other, when you've done that, you can, he's also going to shift between another type of octave, where instead of the first finger being behind everything, the first finger then becomes the root note. So in this example, we could say the D string on the fifth fret and the B string on the seventh fret. And you're just sliding those up and down. And he will alternate between both of these. Yeah? So he'll be going. But that'll become quite clear when we start playing the tune. The song starts with raking the guitar backwards down close to the bridge. Not here. Yeah, you're raking it back to get a very, very tense steel sound. And you're playing with your second finger on the D string on the ninth fret. It's been a while since I've done a YouTube video. And your third finger is on the 10th of the D. So, okay. So that's your first chord. And you are hitting the low E string. Then your next two notes are. Okay, that's three notes. Four, actually. So that's E. Okay, up to the C. E string. On the seventh fret, sorry, A string on the seventh fret, and a D string on the 10th fret. So. Then you go to the octaves I was showing you that apart. So that's. I'm going to tell you only on the high note, yeah? So that's an octave on 10. 10, 8, 7. Sliding from the 8th up to the 10th. Down to the 5th on the B string. And then you're going to slide up and down the 8th to the 10th and back. Altogether, it sounds like this. So, slowly. Then you're going to go. So that's an octave jump, switching between those two variations of doing octaves. Seventh fret with the E, ninth with the ring finger. On the eighth, ninth rather. Sorry. Then there is this little riff, which is start here, because it's all in a sort of D minor, A minor he's playing. So that's on the B string, six, eight, E string, five. B string fifth. Now here he would play. But sometimes you, when you watch the video of him playing it, he'll play. He'll just stretch his finger up there and use his pinky there. Okay. Quick hammer on. Down to the fourth fret. Five, seven, four, five. And now he's playing what would be a D, a sort of a D minor shape with your pinky on the eighth fret of the A string. Yeah. So you have a sort of a D minor with an F bass. And not for the first time in this song, he's going to rake. Whereas at the beginning he raked backwards, he sort of rakes forward here. You almost don't hear those notes. Played slowly, it would be like. But he goes. Okay, so that shape. Timing on that is a little bit weird, and if you was playing that with somebody who's singing, I'll show you exactly where the voice comes in. So. And it's on that. Realizing the form of the stone. That's where the vocal comes in. Realizing the form. Yeah. So. Now you can slide up or hammer on, whatever you want. Hammer on and off. Pull off. Now on the DVD CD-ROM version, this is he doesn't play the sit hands moving thing. He goes straight into. So that's that chord again, scratching down. B string 6-5, G string 7-5. To the D string 7. Then the next little riff goes on the A string 7-8. And there he actually runs the chord back up again. Yeah? So So that's the octave thing again on the B string, A string, 8th fret to 10th and back. So get that sliding effect. Steve Howe doesn't often just go, unless it's appropriate. He uses a lot of slides. Yeah. So, now you're going up to the high E string and you're going to play on the 13th to the 15th. That's the notes. But on the last ones you hit an A bass. Now that's the thing that Steve Howe is doing. He's playing with a hybrid technique of using his guitar pick alongside his fingers. So it gives him a good opportunity to play with a pick when he needs to strum or anything. He needs the attack of a pick, but he doesn't use his nails. And so he'll be playing with this hybrid picking of two fingers. So when you play, the pick is playing the A and the high ring finger is playing the E string. So that's the octaves again, it goes. And that kind of resolves that room. Yeah? Okay, so... Now, in this section, he plays back and forth on the two strings, they are two octaves. You know, that type of thing, that was totally wrong, but he plays. And that's the end of the first section, yeah? So he's playing those octaves. And then he ends raking it back. Okay, I'll play it through for you. Now he lets the guitar ring out there, and then there's a key change. He's now going to go to E. So he's going down from the, he's going up to the from the, what, 16, 16, 14, 12, 11, and he's just playing single notes. And the only two notes that he plays in tandem is the B string and then the A string. But he does a little slide down just to stop it being so static. Yeah. So. It's a slide. Then he goes to an A major 7th and he rakes backwards again. That's the B note. Rake backwards. And then you're playing the high E. Now you're going to go to a C sharp minor and you play the high note and your pick is playing. So, so then once again it's the high, the 12th fret, and then the B and the 11th. And that note there is accompanied by the bass note A. Sometimes even that note, so. Then he plays a little guitar, just a little single line here that goes. Okay. And here he's playing a C sharp minor with that note. I've seen some guys playing it like that with this D minor shape. That's just not right. So it's. And you'll see why he. I'll show you. You'll see the reason why he's playing it like that in a second. Now, so if you, when you play these parts, you should crescendo them up. I forgot what it was. Don't take that pinky off. This chord's a bit of a stretch, to be quite honest, but it's a beautiful chord that he moves down to, and it's an F sharp minor, but you're bringing your pinky up to the A flat minor on the D string. So that's. And you're going to play a run that goes. Playing the top four strings there. Pinky on, off. Now your next chord is D string on the ninth, G string on the eighth, and your pinky on the 11th, and the B string is open. There, they're all playing, all barred. Going to finish on the A major seventh again, A flat seventh. So let me go back to that. Okay. It's a little bit like that other tune. Home world, answers on the postcard. So. And then once again, when you rake down, you're going to go straight into. Oh, sorry. And then back to that C sharp minor. But this time you're playing the A note. So that's a C sharp minor to A, which is a B, but he's playing a G shape there. It's basically his finger is just a capo. He's just capoing everything there and playing chords with those. Yeah, as if there was, as if he had to play the chords just with these three fingers. So. And here you're just going up to the ninth fret on the E string and an A bass. Then he just plays basically a scale of. And then when he hits this high note, it's a very typical Steve Howe move, is he plays this. Yeah? That note, that tension that comes into from there to before he resolves. But that is on the D string, and it's a 10th fret on the D string along with the 12th string on the E. So. And that's it. So when you've got down to here, so from the 8, 9, 11, 12, 11, 9, 12, 10, 9, 11, 9, and back up. And before you hit the 12, D string on the 10th, then you're going to play, which is 12, 10, 8. You got that? Da, da, da. And then you will hit the harmonic on the 12th fret. And you can take your time here. It's a very gentle landing, yeah? And then, whereas in the rest of the tune he's been raking backwards, very close to the bridge, he now moves his pickup towards the neck here, and he's playing open E, 11, 9, 11, open B, open E. Yeah, so. Harmonic on the B string, 12th fret. Pick over here, and as I said, that you're playing that chord there. He didn't play. And there, that chord is right beside. Mm-hmm. screwed that up again. Just let that ring out. Take your time, there's going to be a real shift. Got an email and the top of the email says create mood and drama, you know, advertisements for some photography software. Okay, that is the tune, that's it, Steve Howe. I might do some other Steve Howe stuff, but it seems to be people enjoy that. If you really want more Steve Howe stuff, just ask me in the comments if there's any particular tunes you want to know how to play, based on the acoustic stuff, maybe from that cd-rom. There's a lot of very interesting stuff going on that ROM, different versions of his most popular tunes. Anyway, that's it. I've been told that I have to say this, like and subscribe and press the buttons and all those sort of things. It seems to be the way this YouTube wants everything to work, and I've been told that I must do the same thing. Okay, so I hope to be uploading more videos now that I'm healthy again after a period of very uncertain illness that I went through. And I'm kind of glad to be back. And I want to say thank you to the people who sent me some emails and reminded me and said that they missed my videos and they missed my teaching and me teaching them tunes and stuff. So I appreciate you really do appreciate you writing to me and saying, how are you doing? Haven't heard from you for a while. That was deeply appreciated. That touched me, you know, where I needed it most. So anyway, that's it. Hope to be doing some more tunes for you. I'm now going to do you a 10cc song called Feel the Benefit. If you don't know that tune, it's an acoustic. I just want to show you how to play it on an acoustic version of it. And that should be coming up in the next few days. Okay, that's it. Thank you very much again.